We begin.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm the white male, 6'1", 30 to 35, tending to rock music, white evening at home.
You jogging?
Yes, I am. I'm Bruce.
Hi, I'm Bruce.
Nice to meet you, Bruce.
Thank you.
Won't you sit down?
As I said in my letters, I haven't replied to one of his ads before.
I haven't either. Well, I mean, I haven't placed an ad like this before.
But this time I thought, why not?
Exactly right. Give it a shot. You know, Bruce, I hope I'm not too macho for you.
So far, you seem wonderful.
Thank you so much. You know, you have lovely breasts. That's the first thing I noticed is your breasts. And your contact lenses are also nice.
Thank you. I like the timbre of your voice. Soft.
Thank you. I like your voice as well.
Thank you. I like the smell of youth that you bring.
I need a lover Bob gave that to me.
What?
You know, you kind of remind me of Bob in a certain way. I swing both ways, actually, don't you?
No. I intend for the life to be out.
I'm afraid I've upset you now.
No. It's just I hate gay people.
I'm not gay. I'm bisexual. There they are.
I don't know what one is bisexual.
Well, most children are innately bisexual. If you were to take a child to play with a retreat, you would find that that child is attracted to both sexes.
I bet they would be terrified.
They might be. I dedicated a child to play with a retreat.
I don't think they let you.
I don't actually know any children. You know, Bruce, you have lovely eyes. They're so beautiful.
Thank you.
I feel like I could protect you.
Thank you. My favorite song is Someone to Watch Over Me.
I know that song is somebody. And I forgot the words to that song, Looking for Me. Yeah, it's a great song. You know, Bruce, in some ways you're like a little girl. In other ways, you are quite like a woman.
How am I like a woman?
Well, you dress like a woman. You have eyeshadow like a woman.
You know, you're like a man. You're strong. You shave. I think you could protect me.
Well, yeah, I'm also deeply emotional. I like to cry.
Oh, I wouldn't like that.
I like to cry.
I don't think men should cry unless something falls on them.
That's the kind of sexism I had a program not to show emotion.
Please, don't talk about sexism. You're the one who talked about my breath the minute I said no.
I'm going to cry right now.
Oh, please. Don't cry. What's the matter?
I think you don't like me enough. You've been making eyes at the waiter.
He's the waiter. What's the matter?
You have my children?
Yes.
Well, we agree on all the issues. You like rock music. You also like long walks at the beach. You like quiet evenings at home. We agree on everything. I'm also, you're not very shallow. You don't like reading People magazines, for example.
I do read People magazines. I write for it, too.
I write for it, too. I'm a freelancer. I send in a letter. They published one.
Oh, what was that about?
Well, I wanted to see Terry Gilmore executed on television.
Oh, I remember that one.
Say, do you identify with Jill Clayburgh as an unmarried woman?
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, we agree on everything. I could try again.
Don't cry. I don't recommend you cry.
Well, you'd like Bob, then. You know, Bob. I feel like I'm irritating you.
If they get too loud, you can test them.
I feel like I'm irritating you.
No. It's just... Why?
It's hard to get to know someone?
No, it's hard to get to know someone in a way that has never come, and I'd like to go
on. You know what? Let's just start over. Hi. I'm Bruce.
Hi, I'm Bruce.
Bruce, that's a lovely name.
Thank you.
You're wearing a lovely dress.
Thank you. You know, Bruce, I like your neck. It goes well with your chest hair.
I like your nail polish.
Thank you. I had it on my toes too.
Oh, can I see?
Really?
Oh my goodness. I think it's so great that you don't bring enough with me to put your feet on the table.
I didn't put my feet on the table. I put my foot hoping to get the waiter's attention.
We agree on everything. This is amazing.
Oh, look at that.
I feel like, do you want me to, you're too dependent on me. It's like you want me to put up the storm windows or something. I think you should put up the storm windows. You're right, I'm wrong. We agree.
What kind of child is this?
What kind of childhood did you have?
Nuns. I was raised by nuns. They ruined me. I don't even believe in God anymore. I believe in bran cereal. It helps to prevent colon cancer. Will you marry me? I would like you to marry me. Or something like that.
Was I?
I feel ready in my life.
I feel ready in my life to make a commitment. We'll move to the country. We'll have two cars. Bob will live over the garage. Everything will be wonderful.
What? I don't feel ready.
I don't feel ready to make a commitment. I think I need to get to know you then.
Line.
Please let go. This is the line was, I don't feel ready to make a long-term commitment. I think you're insane. I'm going to go now.
I don't feel ready to make a long-term commitment, though. I think you're insane.
No, no, wait. Please. They've got a great salad bar. Listen. Prudence. You're afraid of life, aren't you? Your instinct is to run away. You're afraid of emotion, of feelings. And that's wrong, Prudence. because then you have no passion. Did you see that play, Equus, where the horse felt it was better to blind 8 horses in a stable rather than live without passion? I'm ready in my life to blind the horses, Bruton.
You ought to tell me that now, Bruton.
What? You missed the message.
I didn't miss the metaphor. I made a joke.
You totally missed the metaphor. I could never love someone that misses the metaphor.
What? How much should have you committed?
Committed? I'm not the one afraid of commitment. You are.
Who is that? Oh,
Psyop. Listen, I was going to have a nice dinner with you here tonight. We were going to go see that play about trees and wooden clogs. We were going to go back to my place and have sexual intercourse. But forget about it. I think you should go.
You're not the one who's rejecting me. You're a fuck-off idiot. I'm rejecting you.
You're a rigid bitch.
Nothing seems to get the waiter's attention, does it?
No.
Yeah, I think both of you guys.